Hey folks, welcome to the Alliance Pro Wrestling Network podcast. I'm your host, Lewis Carlin. We're heard right here on the Alliance Pro Wrestling Network. Impact Wrestling's Under Siege has come and gone, and we have brand new Knockouts Tag Team Champions, Tasha Steelz, Kiera Hogan, Fire and Flava, regain the Impact Wrestling Knockouts Tag Team titles, and I couldn't be happier. They are clearly the best tag team in the Knockouts division right now. They are clearly one of the best reasons to watch Impact Wrestling right now. And yes, I understand that they had to put the titles on Ellering and Grace, with Ellering making her debut, give her a little push, give her a little rub, put the championship on her in her debut match to make her seem a little special. But I wasn't a fan of that. I thought Fire and Flava should have held on to those titles. And I am so glad that Kiera Hogan and Tasha Steelz have regained the tag team titles, and they regained it tonight on Under Siege in a great match against Grace and Ellering. Happy they put the titles back on them. I was afraid that they weren't going to regain the titles. I predicted them to win. I was hoping they would win. And thank goodness the Knockouts Tag Team titles are on the best Knockouts Tag Team in Impact Wrestling right now, Fire and Flava, Kiera Hogan, Tasha Steelz. So you have to think, what's next for Fire and Flava? Could be Grace and Ellering getting a rematch, which they will lose. Of course, I don't see Grace and Ellering getting regaining those titles. I see Fire and Flava holding on to them. I kind of think that maybe Grace took the loss. Tasha Steelz pinned Grace for the win. Kind of think that maybe if there's a rematch and Grace loses again, that we might see a Grace Ellering feud. Ellering might get a little upset and maybe turn on Grace. Something along that nature there. I can see that rematch happening. I could also, you got Taylor Wilde, Neil Dashwood as a tag team. They were victorious at Under Siege as well against Kimberly and Susan. And Taylor Wilde, who tells Dashwood on Impact Wrestling TV that they're not really friends, kind of seemed like she was kind of okay when they were taking the pictures, when Caleb with a K was taking the victory pictures after the match, and they were Tennille Dashwood and Taylor Wilde were standing next to each other. Taylor Wilde seemed like she might have been okay with it, so maybe they will continue as a tag team. Maybe they will get a shot at Fire and Flava. And then you got to think Slammiversary, July 17th, Slammiversary. We hope we see the Iconics showing up in Impact Wrestling, and the Iconics and a Fire and Flava feud for the Knockouts Tag Team titles would be absolutely fantastic. I don't think they should take the titles off Fire and Flava. I think they should keep the titles on them for quite some time. You're thinking maybe Taylor Wilde, Tennille Dashwood getting a shot, but I see Tennille Dashwood kind of turning on Taylor Wilde, just like we might see Ellering turning on Jordynne Grace. I'm not saying they're both going to happen, but you kind of think that maybe something like that's going to happen. And I can see Dashwood turning on Wilde in a tag team match for the title, if they get a shot at the titles. I think Kiera Hogan, Tasha Steelz, as I said, they are one of the best things right now in Impact Wrestling, one of the best reasons to watch Impact Wrestling. They're very talented, great, great tag team, and I think that they should hold those belts. Nobody deserves to have those belts more than Fire and Flava, and I couldn't be happier again that the belts are around their waists for a second time. And there was another fantastic match, which I was very happy at the outcome as well. Josh Alexander retaining the X Division Championship in an absolutely tremendous match against El Phantasmo. I said in the last podcast that Josh Alexander absolutely had to win this match, not just for Josh Alexander, for Impact Wrestling, because if El Phantasmo won the X Division title, it really would have made Impact Wrestling stars look really weak, because Kenny Omega comes in, wins the Impact Wrestling World title. Finn Juice comes in, they win the New Japan Pro Wrestling. Finn Juice comes in, and they win the Impact Wrestling Tag Team titles. I should mention, but I think everybody knows Kenny Omega is with AEW, and he comes in, wins the Impact title. And if El Fantasma had defeated Josh Alexander for the X Division Championship, it really would have made the Impact roster look weak. So I'm really happy that Josh Alexander retains. But I was pumped for that match. It was a tremendous, tremendous match between two great, great stars. I hope it's not the last of El Fantasmo. I hope we see him again. Again, he's tremendous, tremendous athlete, as is Josh Alexander. Josh Alexander, one of the best in the world right now. I would love to see him cash in on option C and go after the Impact Wrestling World title. But I think he's going to hold that X Division title for a few more months. We'll see what happens from there. I'm sure we're going to have a number one contenders match again to see who will be the next challenger for Josh Alexander. They might have that. We might just see an outright feud. Phantasmo might want a rematch. Anything is over. I would love to see Josh Alexander actually show up at AEW with the X Division title. I want to see another Impact Wrestling star showing up on AEW, whether it's Deonna Purrazzo, whether it's Sami Callihan. I would love to see Josh Alexander with the X Division title, you know, challenging anybody in AEW, or for anybody in AEW, an X Division title match, and wrestle them on AEW Dynamite and defeat them on AEW Dynamite. I think that would be absolutely fantastic. As I said, Josh Alexander, one of the best in the world right now, and he is definitely, definitely worthy of carrying that X Division championship, and he's proven it, and I think he's going to hold it for quite some time. Just get a little stability, because I know they were playing hot potato a little bit with X Division title. But let's get a little stability, really build up Josh Alexander as one of the top X Division stars of all time. I think he already is. I think you could put Josh Alexander in a sentence with any other X Division champion. Compare him to any other X Division champion, and he holds his own. I mean, whether it's AJ Styles, whether it's Christopher Daniels, Josh Alexander is right up there with one of the greats, in my opinion. Okay, and on that note, I'm going to say thank you very much for listening to me today. Again, just want to say one more thing. Under Siege was actually a very, very good show. If you haven't checked it out, do check it out. Great, great show. I'm not going to, just in case you haven't seen it yet and you're watching this, I'm not going to give away any other spoilers. I've already given away two. Not going to give any other spoilers away. I will be back tomorrow, either here or on the Impact Lounge, or both. You never know. And I'll be back, and I'll be reporting more stuff, talking about more pro wrestling news. And until then, thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye. And stay safe, everyone. So long. Bye-bye.